chasenarsatdroidmotorx.com, and as you all know, CES is finally here. NVIDIA kicked off the conference in a big way with their announcement of probably one of the most exciting projects that I've heard of in a while, Project Shield. Now, Project Shield could very well be vaporware. It could just be a platform for developers to use to develop their games on, or it could be the new revolution in mobile gaming. NVIDIA started out by unveiling their new Tegra 4 processors. The Tegra 4 processors are just building on the success of Tegra 3. It is another quad-core processor, but this time the GPU has 72 cores. So this should be the ultimate in graphics processing for mobile gaming, mobile video, and it does support 4K resolution, which will future-proof devices. So the Tegra 4 announcement was exciting in and of itself, being that that is a product that is ready to ship. It will be shipping in the first half of 2013. It should be in mobile devices since it does support LTE, and it should be in tablets. But it's also going to be in NVIDIA's new Project Shield, which is their version of a mobile console. Basically, Project Shield looks like an Xbox 360 controller on steroids. The controller packs the Tegra 4 quad-core processor. It should give you about 5 to 10 hours of gaming. It also packs a 5-inch 720p display, an awesome audio system, microSD, HDMI out, and USB charging. And did I say that it supports 4K resolution? So not only do you have that awesome 720p screen built into the device, but you can actually play back your gaming on a massive 85-inch 4K screen if you got that kind of dough. So one of the cool things about Project Shield is that it includes the Tegra Zone, where you can purchase all of the games that are supported by Tegra for the ultimate gaming experience. But on top of Tegra Zone, with a click of a button, you can enable a full-on Nexus-like vanilla Android experience, which you can push out to your high-definition television. So you can experience things like Google Play, Google Movies, Google Music, and all of that awesomeness, including internet browsing on any 1080p or 4K display. With the release of Project Shield, they're also going to be pushing out their grid system, which allows you to play games off of NVIDIA servers. So you won't actually have to play them from your console, you'll actually be using their powerful servers at NVIDIA to play your game on your new Project Shield. Furthermore, you'll be able to play Steam games, so you'll be able to carry over your PC gaming experience directly to your new Project Shield device. NVIDIA's Project Shield is now in beta stages, but it's expected to release sometime in quarter 2 of 2013. I'm hoping that this is not vaporware. It's looking pretty exciting. What do you guys think about this new project from NVIDIA? Is this something that you guys would throw money at? Or is it something that you don't think there's really a market for? We saw Online flopped. We saw MOGA is not, it's actually doing pretty well. So there is this need to migrate towards mobile gaming, and not in the sense of like a PlayStation Portable, but you know, we have all these cheap, low-priced Android games. We just need a really good way to control them and to push them to our televisions. I think games like Need for Speed Most Wanted, if we could bring like Assassin's Creed or Call of Duty to the mobile Android platform, I think that this thing really could just really be an awesome platform. I think that NVIDIA may have struck gold with this. What do you guys think? Leave your comments in the comment section below. Be sure to check me out at droidmotorx.com, where I'm going to have lots of articles on things that release at CES. Pretty excited about all that's going on there. Of course, there's lots and lots of talk about 4K, and we know that we're going to probably see some flexible screens from Samsung. Samsung's event starts here in just a few minutes, so I'm going to check out that, and hopefully I have some articles up for you guys tonight. You can also follow me on Twitter, and I'll tweet out some important things or things that are important to me. Follow me on Twitter at DroidMotorX. Thanks, guys, for watching. I'll see you in the next one.